Hi everyone. In this video, we'll have the opportunity to explore time-phase budgets, see how we construct time-phase budgets, and of course, we will be able to differentiate between time-phase budget and cash flows. Well, let's come back to our favorite project. So you have the typical table, activities, predecessor, duration, and this time the new column is cost. So here, you would put the total cost of the activity. This is expressed in $1,000, so $20,000 for framing, $30,000 for drying, and so on. And what you want to do is to have an idea of the development of the expenses during time. The first thing that one should do is to find what we call PPC, which is the per period cost. Obviously, the per period cost is going to be equal to the total cost over the duration. So that's $5,000 per week. And we're doing an assumption here. The assumption is that the expenses will happen proportionally. This is a very valid assumption for when we are developing time-phased budgets, although there would be some cases that we would like to do it a little bit different. If we do the same for B, that would be 30,000 over 6 weeks duration, which is again 5 per week. And we do this for all the activities and we get the relevant results. All right. So what's the next step? The next step would be to put these. We either keep it in mind, or as to make things a little bit easier for us, we can just put these costs at the relevant places during the week. So you see that I'm depicting the costs on every week. So this is 0.5. That's 2.5, okay, $2,500 a week. That's 10. That's 5 and 5. 1 and 1. Okay, we have also some indirect costs. There are some costs in the projects that are direct, and this means that we can directly understand and assign them to specific activities. And there are some costs which are indirect. So indirect costs might be, for instance, a salary of the portion of a salary of a secretary who works for the project, answering the calls for the projects, or it might be the cost of the consumption of power and water for the work site. So these costs cannot be directly attributed to a specific activity, and that's why they're called indirect. So in this case, we'll have direct costs, which is $1,000 per week. The first thing that we can do now is for each week to sum the direct costs existing. And that would be, so here would be the sum of all the costs happening during week one. In this case, we only have activity A happening in week one, so the only direct cost would be the one from activity A. So that's it. And if we do this for all the weeks, we come up here and we see, for instance, just an example, under week 5, we have both activities B and C happening, $5,000 from activity B and $2,500 from activity C. That makes a sum of $7,500 under week 5. But we also have some indirect costs each week. Remember that these are expressed in thousands, so 1,000 per week would be 1 here. And that would be the same for every week. This is how we work out indirect costs, same every week, or every period if you prefer. And the total budget will be the sum of direct and indirect costs. So that would be the money that we are supposed to spend for each week of the project execution. The time-phased budget is exactly that. It's that profile, this profile of money expenses for the completion of the work for each period as per the schedule, as per the planned schedule, but is usually presented in a cumulative way. So under week one, you have a total budget of week one. Under week two, you will have budget for week two plus all the previous expenses. So this is 12. The same for week three. The cost of week three plus the previous expenses. And this will obviously only be increasing up to the level of $106,000. So the overall cost covering direct and indirect costs is $106,000. There you are. That's the final cost. If we do a diagram for that, the diagram would be like that. So we have a typical curve. This is a very small project, so it doesn't look like the usual S curve, but usually what you're going to have is a typical time-phased budget will look like an S curve. So something like that, which is not the case here because the project is very small. Usually you have a slow increase in cumulative costs initially because there are no many expensive things happening initially. Then you have a center phase where you have the most expenses, and then phasing off of the project where the expenses are relatively low as well. So what we have done up to this point is that we have created the time-phased budget. Okay, what's the difference now between a time-phased budget and a cash flow? There are two things that we haven't worried at all about in this problem. And let's see, I have an addition here, line 13, and the addition is the payment. So what we haven't examined in the time-phased budget is what's going to happen if you have some payments. That's one thing. The other thing, so we had only expenses before. The other thing is when in reality these expenses are going to happen. So I might be committed when I'm doing, when I have fulfilled 1 week, when I have completed 1 week of aiming, I might have been committed to my subcontractors that I'm going to spend $5,000 for the work done, but this doesn't mean that I'm going to pay this $5,000 at the very end of week one. I might have an agreement with them and say that I'm going to pay you in 2 weeks' time. And this would be when the expense would be recorded in a cash flow. So the cash flow is telling us not about the commitment of payment, but when the exact payment is happening. So in this case, I haven't changed anything. I assumed that everything is really paid. So the expenses are really paid when they occur. But on the other hand, what I've done is that I've introduced some payments. So there are three payments of $50,000 at weeks 5, 10, and 14. And as you can see now, the curve is not an S curve anymore. So what is happening is that I have some peaks, and these peaks will tell me the amount of money that I need to invest myself before I get paid from the customer. That is something that is usually happening in construction projects. So I'm investing money, and then at some time in time I get a payment, and then I go back having a profit here, and then I use this profit and I go up again and I put my money in, and then I get another payment and I have some profit again, and in the end the last point will tell me the overall point or the overall profit of the project. So all in all, what has happened is I spent $106,000, remember from a previous diagram. I received $150,000, so the difference is $44,000, which is the profit for this project. And that would be the difference between a cash flow, where I take into account when the money is really spent, and any inflows, any payments that I get, versus the time-phased budget, where I only have expenses and practically do not put in when exactly the money is spent, but when I am committed to spend that money.